everybody, I'm Dee.
And I'm Jay,
and we are ParoDeeJay.
It is time again! This might be the first time in a while where we have actually got the right month for the MunchPak. This is our July MunchPak.
Is it still July?
I mean, I think this video is coming out on the 31st of July,
hey,
so we barely
squeezed
it in there.
Yeah.
Alright, now, this one, box was a little weird because normally it's completely wrapped in plastic. This one just had like a little slip of tape on it.
Should we be concerned?
I'm hoping not. We've had them like that before where they're not... Oh, I'm also fedorable, by the way.
Oh, yeah, very.
Anyway, I don't know. I don't... Just ignore the wardrobe choices.
The book that we will end up using at some point.
Never.
Probably.
Never. Alright, y'all peek in here. Take a little look and see if anything's fun. Oh, wow. Oh, I see... Oh, you know, I'm not supposed to be looking around the edge.
I see you.
Let's go biggie and baggie and see what's happening. All right, that is biggie and baggie. It looks like macaroni and cheese.
Oh, wow.
Is that called Zoomers? What the heck? Zoomers? Something flavored. Gosh, that's hard to read from afar.
Cheese wheel.
Look at those things.
They kind of look pretzels.
Wow.
Or honeycomb cereal.
Wheel made of cheese. Crunchy cheese flavored wheels. Now, flavor has a U in it, so that's going to lead me to certain parts. You know what?
I'm the UK.
This could be from Canada, too.
Oh, yeah, maybe.
Where are you from? Keep your country clean. Made in the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago.
Yeah.
I was not going to guess.
Are
cheesy
they a British,
wheels.
Like...
Oh.
Yeah.
Influence.
Yeah. That makes sense.
All right. Let's see how cheesy wheels go. We've had cheesy feet. We've had... Oh, I smell these already.
Have lots of cheesy incarnations of chips.
They're strong. And I don't know.
They are bright. Oh, that is that very fake cheese smell.
Well, yeah, they're ripping them.
Super bright.
A real hunk of cheese in this bag. I mean, you know, you come to expect these from Cheetos and from.
It's a wheel, not a steering wheel.
I always wanted to chew on a hunk of a car. They smell very artificial, but you know, like you said, what am I expecting? A big piece of cheese in here? No.
All right.
They're crispy. I like the texture. Oh.
Actually, they taste a lot better than they smell.
Yeah. Those are good, actually.
Tastes like Cheetos Puffs. Well, I mean, they do.
Are they made by the same? No.
They're good. Nice, airy crispiness to it.
Very tangy cheese.
That's good.
Very crispy. You know, kind of what you would expect.
Recommend.
I'm a Cheetos Puffs. When it comes to the Puffs versus the classic Cheetos Crunch Crunches.
Oh, no, I like the crunchy ones. I like both. Equal opportunists, but if I had to pick... I like the crispy one.
No, I'm a Cheetos Puffs. I don't know. Oh, watch, I'm making stuff go all over the room.
Kind of tastes like cheese balls, too. Yeah, cheese
the
balls.
Big
yeah, oh, did you guys tubs? Ever get those? Everyone had that at one point, like in college, you know, that's what you did.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Do they even sell that anymore?
I think they do. I've seen.
We're not buying.
You probably have to go to Costco or Sam's Club. Some big outlet.
I bet they do.
All right, now these may or may not be Sour Patch because I may or may not peek around the edge while everybody else was peeking. Sour, no, this just says Sour Patch Kids.
Oh. It says something at the top, though.
It does. Is there anything special about these?
Maynard,
is the company that makes...
They're giant.
Sour...
I think we've had these.
Sour Cherry Blasters.
I believe we've had them.
They sound familiar. It gets to a point, you know, when you've been opening these boxes for 5 going on 6 years, you start getting some duplicate snacks.
It's a long time.
These are from Canada.
That means they're good.
They're going to be delicious. Best before 2023. Hey, we're good.
Yeah. It's only the end of July.
I still have 22. Orange on my fingers.
Yeah, and my feet on my legs.
Just excuse. So are these are all, they're so tiny. Okay.
They look cute.
Well.
Are they super tiny?
Yeah. The mammoth candy.
Well, it didn't say mammoth.
See if you can dig one out of there.
Teeny baby cherries.
They're very small. They're actually about the size of a cherry.
The size of your fingernail.
That's realistic. I've had cherries bigger than that.
Boop.
Oh.
Oh, they are soft.
Sour right away. Very soft.
Ooh. Tangy.
Softer than... It's been a long time since I've had a Sour Patch Kid, but I think they're softer than a Sour Patch Kid.
Because they're kind of supposed to have like a gushy thing in the middle.
Ew. Blaster. Gross. Oh.
Well, yeah, but it's not like... What were the things like...
Gushers.
Oh, duh.
Yep, the stuff with the gushy stuff
the
in
gushy
the middle.
Thing. You know, gushers.
They were very original when
it's
they
made
those.
It's not like that.
There.
It's very subtle.
Oh, these are addictive.
They're really good, though. No, I'm good.
I like those.
I already had dinner. I'm good.
Those are going to be all mine.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but...
Those are tasty.
I know the thing about Sour Patch Kids is sour then sweet. I kind of got sour and then just not as sour. It didn't really go boom sweet at the end.
Oh no, it was sweet. I got sweet then sour.
Maybe my sweet buds are busted.
Or my
sour buds. Ooh, that feels like a... I feel, all right, let's do the baggy. Oh no, that I know what that feels like. I gotta save that.
No, not a corn.
No, it's in a good way. All right, let's try these first. Y'all know I gotta cheat and take some things out in the right order. I see the word herbs. What does that say? Cracks?
Yeah, it's like those sticks.
Cracks sticks. Herbs.
Herb flavored crack sticks.
Okay, and they're mixing up, muddling a whole bunch of herbs in there.
Should we be concerned about the herbs?
I don't know. All right, so the first language on here says BG. So does that mean?
Bulgaria?
I'm going to say Bulgaria.
That's a good guess.
I'm going to look in the
book. See, we're using the book. I told you.
Guys, don't. I'm going to use the book over here so nobody can know.
We're up here.
Oh, Romania.
Romania. That's okay. The same.
No.
Not at all.
Why was the first language BG? All right, Romania then, for cracks sticks.
Herbs. You gotta get all the words in there. All right,
what kind of... It smells like a oregano, like a pizza mm-hmm. blend.
Yeah.
I was trying to read the ingredients and that didn't happen.
That's not right.
It smells like pizza. Pizza flavored. So crack I don't know sticks. What herbs are being muddled. This actually just looks like a giant bowl of peppercorns. Are these all peppercorns?
I hope not.
Can we? That literally just looks like a whole, like green peppercorns, pink peppercorns. I think it's pepper crackers.
I'm going to eat it.
Oh, it really smells like a pizza. I'm going to eat two. Yeah,
tastes like pizza flavoring. Because this is not actually what pizza tastes like. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. It's the seasoning that seasons a pizza sauce.
Correct.
Mm-hmm.
But pizza doesn't taste no.
It's funny though, because we do stuff like that. Like when you think of something that's pumpkin pie flavored, it's the spices that go into a pumpkin pie. Or, you know, if
pumpkin
you think
it doesn't taste like that.
Right. You could be like, oh, this is pumpkin flavored, and it's going to be like a squash.
Cinnamon,
nutmeg. No, but this is
pretty good.
Oregano. Yeah,
it's really subtle.
I like them. Mm-hmm. I don't mind a good subtle. I don't have to get slapped in the face by somebody's herbs. Are there English ingredients back? Oh, no. I really don't know what the herbs are. It's just going to be a mystery.
It'll be all right. They're good, though.
They're good till 2023 also.
We're doing well.
Mm. Oh, man. What do I want last?
I don't know. Better not be the corn stick, though.
Excuse me. I'm chewing on herbs. All right, let's go ahead and go with the one that I know what it is. I felt the Stroop Waffle. I can always feel a Stroop Waffle. So this actually, if it focuses, it has the word Dutch on it. Oh, it says right there. I think that's pretty much going to give away where it's made from. Is this a genuine made in the Netherlands Dutch Stroop Waffle?
Caramel? Like we've had one before.
I don't... Finger licking Dutch. I don't remember that brand.
Maybe that didn't translate quite right.
It's distributed by Pennsylvania, which kind of makes sense.
Yeah.
Please tell me you're actually made, you know what, the Netherlands. You're made in the Netherlands.
Sweet.
I think I saw that in the book too. When
authentic.
Gosh, we've only had Canadian Stroop Waffles.
Are you sure we haven't?
We may have.
I'm pretty sure.
Oh, you probably don't even want a whole.
No.
All right, let's do half of a half.
I mean, I like them, but.
Okay, we're going to save half.
Jay's treat.
For later, and I'll give you, you get the.
Little half.
Thanks.
I get the big half. They smell
so good. Cinnamon. Okay. I smell cinnamon.
Just smell it.
I know you're supposed to put these on like a cup of hot tea.
Oh.
We ain't got time for that. We just tear into them and eat them.
If you guys want to sit here and look at our background, we can go make some tea.
But... I guess every munch pack, we should have like a cup of tea on standby in case some snack calls for it.
Very good.
Okay.
Also subtle.
Good texture. Oh yeah, where's that sweet caramel slapping me in the face?
Well, it's not a caramel, is it?
I think that's what it said. Caramel waffle cookie.
Okay.
That is very subtle, actually. Canada, y'all been amping up the flavors of Stroop Waffles, because is this how it's supposed to be?
I put maple syrup in it.
Nothing wrong with that.
No.
Mm-hmm.
It's good. It's a little more subtle than we're used to, though.
I like the texture, though.
Mm-hmm. Oh, no, the texture's great.
Mm-hmm. It's kind of flaky. Makes me think of like a crust.
Yeah.
Like a pie crust.
Mm-hmm. We're good at describing food.
Mm-hmm. Like a short crust? I don't know anything about crust.
It's good. Eat it.
Just crust us. It's delicious.
Crust us.
All right. So this last thing is like a bar. Yeah. I think this is... Oh, gosh. Is it going to be your Dollar Tree wafers again? Princesa Long as zebra.
Zebra. Long zebra cracker cookies.
Princess long zebras.
Cool.
Okay.
Creative.
It looks like they're going for like a cookies and cream kind of
thing.
They're
black and white. I get it.
Yeah, yeah. You're also from Facebook. No, that's not where you're made. Let's check.
Get the book.
I know. I see a word, but I don't want to be wrong. It starts with a P. Poland is right.
Poland. Okay.
So my because I saw Polska on the back, so I thought. Nah, forget it. You're home to Bel Air.
Nice.
All right, let's see. Are you Dollar Tree worthy or are you not Dollar Tree worthy? There's some good stuff at the Dollar Tree.
Yeah, I think they're like $1.25.
It's not a dollar anymore. You're correct.
$1.10. We haven't been in a long time.
I think it's a buck and a quarter.
Buck and a quarter right. Tree.
Bam. All right, I'll give you the little. See how generous I am giving you the little.
No,
pieces?
I don't want anything bigger.
Okay, so on first sight, chocolate wafers, vanilla cream.
They don't
cream.
Smell like anything.
Uh huh. Smells like dollars.
Nothing. Yep,
smells just like a dollar. Smells like I pulled a fresh dollar out of my pocket, plus tax, and just walked into the store. Mm-hmm. It crunches like a dollar. Mmm.
That was a pretty good taste.
Mm-hmm. That kind of tastes better than a dollar.
I don't know, I was supposed to rank it.
There's some, like some natural
some
flavors
flavor,
in
yeah.
there. Mm-hmm. The ones from the Dollar Tree are very artificial. There's something genuine about this one.
Maybe it's vanilla.
Maybe.
Maybe real vanilla or something like that. Mm-hmm. It doesn't taste like chemically.
That's some high dollar cookie. And some high dollar cream. That's a $2 tree wafer.
Wow.
I would give a double dollar for that.
Okay.
I guess we did because the box is $10 a month and there's 5 snacks. Actually, the box is $14, but I don't know what the box is.
They changed the rates.
I know, though, that the box is empty.
Aww.
That's one thing I do know.
That means it comes to the end of another MunchPak series.
I know. I kind of liked everything.
Yeah.
What's your favorite? The Stroop Waffle's delicious, but
I really like the Sour Patch Kids.
Okay, they're really good.
Those are good.
And then, yeah, if I had to pick up one thing right now and eat it again, it's going to be the sour cherries.
You can have.
But you know what the next one might be? The $2, the dollar wafers.
I would do
they
the cheese wheels.
Really good.
The cheese wheels were good. No complaints on July box. Everything was tasty and there were no weird surprises.
We are rewarded for doing it in the proper month. Let's see if we can keep it up for
it
August, actually.
Maybe.
But that's it. So thanks for hanging out for another month of us chewing on some international snacks. If you have not already, be sure to subscribe to the channel. Become a Paromaniac today. Socialize all our media, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter.
Yep. And until next time.
Rock on.
Bye.